Hello everyone and welcome to the PUQcloud channel, in our series about modules. Today, I'm going to show you and tell you about the Proxmox KVM module for WHMCS. This module allows you to sell virtual machines to your clients directly through WHMCS. It's lightweight, easy to install, and requires no changes to your Proxmox server. Thanks to its API-based integration, you can connect any Proxmox server in just a few minutes. In today's video, my test Proxmox server is located in our Canadian office. I'm on the same local network with it. Our test WHMCS installation, however, is running in a European data center. Still, I easily connected the Proxmox server to WHMCS via the API. Let's start by taking a look at how I've prepared Proxmox for use with the module. I've already uploaded all the necessary VM templates, and the server is added in WHMCS and ready to go. Now let's go back to the WHMCS client area and place an order for a virtual machine. During the order process, we enter a password, select all the required options, and proceed to the next step. In the Backups drop-down menu, we choose how many backups will be available for this virtual machine. In the Snapshots drop-down, we select the number of snapshots the VM can have. Then, in the Operating System drop-down, we choose which OS will be installed on the virtual machine. After that, we confirm the configuration, proceed to checkout, and complete the order. After placing the order, the virtual machine is automatically deployed. We'll now watch this entire process from the Proxmox console. First, the system clones the selected template with the operating system the client chose. Depending on the Proxmox server's performance and the template size, this step may take some time. While the deployment is in progress, the client area in WHMCS shows a warning alert that the virtual machine is currently being deployed and configured. During this time, all management functions for the VM are temporarily frozen. The client can't interact with the service until the deployment finishes successfully. The deployment process in our module works as follows. Right after the order is placed, the template cloning starts immediately. Then, with each WHMCS cron job run, the module checks if the cloning has completed. If it's still in progress, the module waits and tries again during the next cron run. This means there might be a short delay between cloning and the next deployment steps, depending on your WHMCS cron interval. If your cron runs every minute, the wait time will be minimal. Once cloning is finished, the module proceeds with configuring the VM. Resizing the system disk. Applying disk limits like IOPS and bandwidth. Setting RAM and CPU core count. Configuring network settings like bandwidth, VLANs, and firewall rules. The final step is attaching the CloudInit virtual disk and mounting it in the virtual CD-ROM drive. Then the virtual machine is started. Once the VM is up and running, the client gets full access to all control buttons in the WHMCS service management area. After the VM is deployed, the client can access it directly using the noVNC console. Here's how noVNC works in our setup. We provide a dedicated VNC proxy server that you install on a separate machine. This server must have a public IP address and a domain name specifically for noVNC access. That's where your clients will connect. On the back end, this VNC proxy has access to all your Proxmox servers via VNC ports 5900 and up. This setup isolates your Proxmox servers from the public internet. They can stay inside a secure, private network, even behind NAT. This approach also avoids the need to modify or expose your Proxmox servers directly. Next, let's talk about how snapshots work. In the client area, we go to the Snapshots tab, enter a name for the snapshot, and click the Create Snapshot button. This sends a request to the Proxmox server, and the snapshot is created. We can observe the process both on the Proxmox server and in the client panel in real time. Backups work in a similar way. In the Backup Management tab, the client can set a backup schedule, choosing the specific day they want backups to run. Once the schedule is saved, backups are created automatically. we can observe the backup process directly in the Proxmox server console. During backup creation, all VM management functions are temporarily locked until the process is complete. This approach ensures the safety and consistency of the backup. To restore a backup, the client simply clicks the Restore button, and that's what I'll demonstrate now. However, to protect users from accidental restores, the system only allows a restore if the virtual machine is powered off. If it's still running, an error message will appear. You can power off the VM forcefully using the Control Panel buttons, but in this case, I'll log into the virtual machine and shut it down properly through the console. Returning to the restore process, having the virtual machine powered off helps the client avoid confusion and prevents accidentally restoring the wrong VM. Now we can watch the actual restore process. While the VM is being restored, all control buttons and tools in the client panel are disabled to avoid interference. Once the restore is successfully completed, the virtual machine will automatically power on and resume operation. A notification is also sent to the client, informing them that the VM has been restored from a backup. Since this process can take some time depending on the system and backup size, the next feature I want to show is mounting an ISO image to the client's virtual machine. You can provide different ISO images, so the client can choose which one to mount. It's important that the VM has a virtual CD-ROM drive. Without it, mounting an ISO image won't be possible. Mounting and unmounting the ISO image happens with just a button click, and the module takes care of the rest automatically. And of course, if the client needs to reinstall their virtual machine, they can do that using the Reinstall menu option. Just like with backups, the VM must be powered off before reinstalling. This ensures the client is reinstalling the correct machine. To prevent accidental reinstallation, we've added a confirmation field. The client must manually type the word reinstall in uppercase. Copy-pasting is disabled. This approach ensures that the client fully understands what they're doing and the consequences of this action. The reinstallation process starts by destroying the existing virtual machine. Then, the system clones a fresh template, just like in the initial deployment. From that point on, the process follows the same steps as during the original VM deployment. Once the reinstallation is complete, the client receives an email notification that the VM has been reinstalled, along with the new login credentials for the operating system. Next, I'll show you how the virtual machine upgrade process works when switching to a higher package. With a standard WHMCS upgrade, once the procedure is completed and the invoice is paid, the VM upgrade begins automatically. The virtual machine is first shut down, then all necessary parameters are updated, such as CPU, RAM, disk, and so on. After the update is complete, the VM is powered back on, and the client can continue using it as usual. During the upgrade process, all client-side controls are frozen and temporarily unavailable. The last automation feature is service termination. If the client requests termination, or the service reaches its scheduled termination date, the system handles everything automatically. All backups, the VM disk, and the virtual machine itself will be deleted without manual intervention. As you've seen throughout this video, our Proxmox KVM module for WHMCS provides a complete automation system for managing virtual machines. From ordering and automatic deployment, to snapshot management, backups, reinstallation, upgrades, and termination, everything is handled seamlessly with minimal manual work. This module makes it incredibly easy to launch your own cloud hosting business and start selling virtual machines to your clients with full control and transparency. You don't need to modify your Proxmox server. Everything works via the standard API. At PUQcloud, we've built this solution with flexibility in mind. We're also ready to adapt the module for your company's specific needs, whether it's custom provisioning logic, branding, or integration with other systems. The module is actively maintained and improved, and we're constantly adding new features. Your feedback is very important to us. It helps shape the development and ensures we're building the tools real providers need. Drop your suggestions or questions in the comments. Need a custom solution? Reach out to us, we're happy to collaborate. If you like this video, give us a like. Subscribe to our channel to stay updated with new modules, tutorials, and behind-the-scenes development of PUQcloud. And don't forget to turn on notifications so you don't miss anything important. Thanks for watching. See you in the next episode.